Welcome back to the channel. I appreciate you guys for stopping in. We're on Hunter x Hunter episode 112. And shit is finally going down. I did not expect the people that jumped off of the dragon to be Netero and Grandfather Zoldyck, but it is. I assumed that Netero was a possibility, but I never considered the fact that he would come with one of the Zoldycks. And everybody else is now in front of this man on the stairs. It's just about to get real. I don't really have much to say. We just got to kind of see how this plays out. So let's dive in. Monster and monster.
Kiruaが 宮殿に突入した瞬間、思ったことは、
やっぱりな。
であった。ピトーの縁は全く感じられず、目の前には1階にいるはずのないユピーが立っているという打ち合わせの段階で、検討にすら上がらなかった状況に直面しても経験によってキルアは平静を保てた。ありえない場面はユピーにとっても同様であったが、ユピーはすぐに考えるのをやめた。
我は盾、身をもって王を守る。
形態変化と好戦的な笑みを見せた時、シュートは動きを止めた。
これ以上接近すると奴は俺を迎え撃つ。その攻撃が万が一にも前にいるはずのナックルたちに命中したら、
ユピーの注意をさらに自分へ向けるため、飛ぶ腕とカゴを操作しようとした瞬間、それは来た。
ドラゴンダイブ。じいさんの知人って
唯一回答を得たキルアがそれゆえ一瞬固まる。
So none of them had any idea that this was happening. They knew Netero would be coming and with a friend, but they didn't know that it was one of the Zoldycks, and they didn't know that he was going to do this dragon dive. I feel like they should probably have known this because it kind of throws off everything, right? They just see shit coming through the ceiling and they're like, what is happening? Is this us? Is it them? Like, obviously, like, again, Killua knows, but everybody else is kind of in the dark.
事情を知らぬ者の衝撃はそれ以上である。その中でただ2名、ゴンとユピーが敵だけを見ていた。
お前の相手はユピーじゃねえだろ。
この時シュートの胸中には全く別の感情が湧いていた。
できるならば世界中の人々に叫びたい。あれがゴンだ。
俺より一回り以上年下の俺の恩人だ。危険や好機と全力で向かい合うことを恐れ逃げて、安全な檻の中で自分の言葉すら隠し、そんな自分が嫌だった。
俺より一回り以上弱かったお前が俺の檻を壊してくれた。生きてお前に言う、ありがとうと。
だが逆境時には独特の思考展開によって本領発揮することに本人すら気づいていない。
どいつだ、誰に攻撃された。見えなかったぞ。飛び道具、近くからか。
箱割れ発動。
神の共犯者と箱割れのコンボが可能であることは無論事前に検証を終えている。
ダメージや異変はねえ。なら今はそれより。
ここまでは討伐軍の思惑通りであった。しかし見事初撃を打ち込んだはずのナックルに戦慄走る。
オーラの底が見えねえ。
戦歴5000を超える経験と勘から相手の力量を数値化してきたナックルにとって、過去最強の対戦相手を据えてすら天秤の対として軽すぎるほどの力を持つ敵、前代未聞の経験である。
仮に10倍の70万オーラだとすると、奴を飛ばすまでに一体。
その時ピトーのまがまがしいオーラが討伐軍の全身を覆った。
西塔2階、迎賓の間、
王は開かずの女と一緒にいる。
くせ者よりも早く王のもとへ参じるために。しかしその直後、跳躍を一瞬後悔するほどの暗涼とした負のエネルギーが向かう場を中心として発散されていることに気づかされる。主君の発しているオーラは今の精神状態が容易に汲み取れるくらいに警戒がなく、
I'm pretty sure that this girl has died. And what's wild is this whole time I thought that there was a chance that it might end up being from either one of the royal guard or the king, but it's most likely from this dragon dive attack. It just hit her. And the king is kind of tending to her, which as much as it sucks if something like that happened to her, it kind of opens up a weakness in him, but at the same time might be pissing him off, which is why the aura suddenly got so strong, the negative aura, and that can make him act a little bit out of character and open some, you know, weaknesses up, so to speak, where they can actually get to him. Kind of like how they did like the comic book style, where there's not really much color, there's just the red for the blood, but otherwise it's just the black and white. I assume them painting his face black is their way of saying, like, he's not happy. It's probably interesting for them to walk in on him tending to a human when it seems like they just want to kill all humans. Hey, I don't know how this goes from here.
王が視線を切ると、再び時が動き始めた。いや、王以外の時間は凍ったままである。王を取らんと侵入してきたはずのくせ者までが、固唾を飲んで足を止めた理由は血に染まる少女、そしてその体を抱く異形なる者の所作全てが見まがうことなく優しさにあふれていたからに他ならない。
I'm upset that she died, man. She was a dope little girl, you know what I mean? I don't know how old she was. She obviously was older than, you know, but she was a tiny little person, kind of. So that's why I get to the... I was really hoping this wasn't going to be how it went.
Pito.
Ha!
通常の王の表情に戻っていた。それが逆に、ピトーを不安にさせた。
小麦を直せ。頼んだぞ。
敵の動きを、ただ立ち止まって見守るという愚行、百戦錬磨の二人が続けたのは、敬意の表れである。一個の生命に対する、慈愛あふれる振る舞い、これを犯してはそもそもの大義を失い人ですらなくなる。
話が随分違うじゃねえかよ。
ゼノがそう問い詰めるのも無理はない。同様の思いはネテロにもあった。
場所を変えるか、その方が都合が良いのはウヌラも同じであろう。
依存のあるはずもない。しかし
まあな、
先手を取られたという思いは拭えない。ピトーが能力を発動した瞬間、致命的な油断。一瞬二人がそう覚悟したのも無理はない。それほどにたやすく悠然と王は二人の視線を横切った。敵もまた遥か怪物。
Interesting. This was not at all how I anticipated any of this going. I did consider for a moment when he did the dragon dive that maybe it could hit her, but I guess I didn't think that it would. But then this happened, and very surprising. And he's kind of honorable as a king as well. He's like, listen, we'll do this somewhere else. Let's not do it here. Mainly because he probably wants nothing more to happen to the girl and her to have the best chance to be, you know, healed and brought back to life. Or I don't know if she's passed yet or how. I have no clue. I'm hoping that she's going to be okay. But he could have even walked between them and pulled one of his attacks with his tail where he just takes their head clean off really quick because they weren't paying all that much attention. So it's just very interesting. I did not see this going this way. It seems like it's going to be a more honorable fight. And I'm curious if they're both going to fight him or if Netero is going to have Grandfather Zoldyck just kind of stick to the side and he's going to fight him on his own. Because it seems like he had paid him a great deal, they said, to help separate the Royal Guard from the king, which means that he probably still planned on a one-on-one with the king. So I don't know exactly how the rest of this will play out, but this shit's going to be dope. Appreciate you guys for stopping in. I will catch you in the next episode, homies. I blow that flower like Mario. I keep that fire in my hand. Smoking so much, it's like all I show. I don't think they understand. I blow that flower like Mario. I keep that fire in my hand. I just be rolling, that's all I know. I don't think they understand. I just be rocking the boat. Got me a bop in a hole. I'm locked in the coast. I got me a shot and I know. So everything I drop is cold. I be like, who wanna blow on an L? We hit the hotel. A couple of bitches, a little Ciroc. Got one of my niggas. We feeling the vibe. This comfortable pimpin'.